Hello and welcome to Blood Bowl Chaos Edition. Now, I played a tournament of this last year. This is the new tournament announcement, although that would be fun. I should do something else with that. I meant to do something with XCOM, but I've sort of fallen out and job started, and that kind of wrecked my schedule with regular recording times, and it hasn't actually been on the cards for a while. Still, I hope to do it before the end of the year. So if you've got XCOM Enemy Unknown and are willing to challenge me to a tournament, well, have a tournament. I'm still going to be looking for 8 players at some stage, though a few slots I do want to give out to certain people. We'll see how that goes on, though. So, this, as I say, Blood Bowl Chaos Edition. Once the cutscene goes away. Yes, so we're going Internet Leagues. I unfortunately did lose my Shadowhold 2012 account, which is a little annoying. I don't know why I've lost it, I just can't get the password for it. None of mine work, and whenever I try to use my capture keys, it only goes to this one, which I made because I couldn't find it. So I probably lost it completely, which is annoying, but you know, new account, and we'll continue going. Basically, what I'm going to do here is I'm going to take a team, one of the ones I've got set up for the old world. Currently, I've got the FC's Registered Mutants, but we might have something else. And we're going to try and just play a few league games. We're going to go upgrade the team as and when. We're going to win some. We're going to lose a lot. And we'll just see how the team evolves over time. This is the current team that I'm probably going to use today. I'm not sure which of these I'm actually going to use in future videos or whether I'm just going to keep this going. This is the Slimes Coming Home, which, as you can see by the names, is mostly Red Dwarf references. If you haven't watched Red Dwarf, don't worry. It doesn't have a lot to do with what I've done here. So we have the last human being alive leading the team to probable death and destruction. We could buy an apothecary, actually. That's one of the things I was debating early on. As it turns out, this team's got 11. We've got no spare players, but having an apothecary for our important players possibly is something I need to consider. But either way, that's available. We can go with that team. We have Aura of the Cheese, which is a Skaven team, and I love Skaven teams. I haven't named any of these, so I'm probably not going to use it this time. I will come up with names and sort it out in the meantime. And then we have FC's Registered Mutants, where we have our Hugbot, we have our our Green Clearance Troubleshooters, possibly, or Internal Security people. Pescals probably shouldn't be that sort of level, but you know, I figured, yeah. And here I just decided, you know, my rosters are absolutely worthless, therefore they are Infrared Citizens. They don't have a clearance letter, because Infrared Clearance don't in the current new edition. So there we have our usual team of superstars. The problem with the Nurgle team is they're very difficult to level up, generally speaking, because they're generally quite useless on the ball. They have no ball skills. Nurgle's Rot means these are very fragile. The Pestigort's also suffer from it, to be fair. Actually, is it Nurgle's Rot? No, it's Decay. Decay they've got. But we can get new Rotters if we kill people. And then we have the Hugbot Ed209, because he's always a feature of most of my Nurgle teams. And we have the Friend Computer logo in Nurgle form. But as I said, the first game we're going to play with is going to be with the Slimes Coming Home. So let's go and get it to join a league, shall we? Unregistered teams. Slimes Coming Home, join the league. And let's go and have a game, shall we? I'm not sure how long this is going to take for matchmaking, so I might cut a little bit of this off. So we just want to fight with the Slimes Coming Home. 4-minute matches. Connecting. We have an opponent almost straight away, which is good. So the Slimes Coming Home against Boombart's Horde. Waiting for his petty cash announcements. I'm probably not going to do that. I have nearly a full Yeah, I don't have a lot there. I'm not going to transfer any gold into that. We have 90,000. It might be worth it for a reroll, but I have a few of them anyway. So what we're going to do here is just go on and take our Bloodwiser Babes, which make our guys a better chance of recovering from knockout. So let's have a look at your team then. So we have 2 War Dancers, 2 Catchers, with a Pass Block ability. Lineman. So basically an unskilled team with 1 upgraded person. Okay, well that's fine. We'll just go into that. Start the match. So the Slime's coming home. It's one. He's only got 1 leaders. Now, Jim, that's not the way to do this. You want the rerolls. Dave is probably going down. The reason why Underworld are better to goblins, generally speaking, is they have mutation as one of their core skills. Mutations have a lot of the better skills, and that's the main reason I've taken these three teams, actually, to be fair. My other favourite teams beyond this, I like humans these days. Even if they do get crushed by halflings in impossible ways. Dark Elves are always one of my favourite teams. Even though, again, they get killed quite a lot. We're going to call Tails. We're waiting for the opponents. He doesn't have a tree man. He has war dancers. Okay, so Dave actually is reasonably strong in front there. On the program.
And I'm happy to be sharing the spectacle with Bob Bifford, our expert summarizer.
Greetings to all of you out there.
I really wish I'd turned this off.
Between the two teams, this match could turn into a massacre.
Exactly. Why do you think people pay good money?
Right, so this is my organization time. So let's think about this. We've got... where's our blitzers at this point? We have blitzer number one, who can go there. And Scatter Bob, who can go there. We'll then need our linesman to be nearby. In fact, it might be worth having... thinking about this at the moment here. We only have the one thrower, so he's our one ball carrier. I can't really do that there, so let's go and just shift people along one space here. I think the general plan with this sort of setup is you know they're probably going to get around us. They probably are, but we're going to have one goblin who's just sort of going to be behind as a support person here. They can sneak past. They are going to sneak past. We will have a thrower who hopefully will have the ball. I'm fine with that. And let's just cut that out there. So I'm not going to go for an aggressive sort of start here. I'm going to let him have his running moves because there's not a lot I can do to stop this, to be honest. And two war dancers. Dodge, leap, block. And he's setting up quite heavily at the back there.
Do you remember Eldril Sideway?
Oh, yeah, we don't care about Eldril. I can't. To every elven
race. Oh, he's a strange one.
Rumor has it that he's mutated.
Stranger still.
Let's just say hi and good luck. Just because I'm a nice person, generally speaking, but I like to have the stats up. Also, let's see if I can remember some of the buttons. That'll do. So that gives me my tackle zones. The problem I've got here is that the vast majority of goblins...
The ball's in play. There's going to be trouble.
They get an extra yard. Darn it. And that's because of their coaching assistance and things. And that couldn't have landed much better for me, honestly. That's going to call... They've at least got to go and grab it now. But they have such a huge advantage on me here, and they can just run around here. I'm surprised you put your linesman. Their catches are only strength 2, so we actually are a match for most... The goblins match their catches. And they decide they want to kill this goblin off, which is fine. Also, war dancers have blodge, which makes them rather awkward to knock down. We only knock down 1 in 6 if we get a dice of that effect. You could have run the catches anyway. I'm starting to think they might be trying a long sort of pass at this stage. Which is definitely possible. But it's a bit... Even wood elves would have an issue here. Oh, have they got... Are we playing speedball rules here? Because I don't think they've got a lot of time here. Alright, time's up.
There was a time when the colleges of magic hadn't yet ruled.
So that resolves that turn. Turn over.
Who could forget the infamous?
Okay, time limit exceeded. We've only got 40 seconds. Okay, can't afford to rush this. Then let's go and annoy a lot more elves if we can. Oh, darn it! Force a reroll. Doesn't work. Boom. We're off to a flying start. A flying start. This is. I should not have set up for 40 seconds. Yeah, he'll go the blodge route here.
Don't forget, children, don't try and do this at home. Remember, these are
they can get a pass here really easily. I should have covered up first before trying a block.
They can start to move forward.
It's a long distance for him to pass it, but elves can do it. He might just depends what he wants to do. He's got 20 seconds. Depends what else he wants to do. He can't afford to hesitate a lot. Going for it. That's probably for an extra plus one if he can get into the bracket. That's a going for it fail.
When he comes round,
and he's knocked one of his guys out. Good start for me. The reason that's a good start for me is I've got somebody I can put on the ball. In fact, I've got two people I can put on the ball. And in fact, because of my team with mostly running people, I can actually try and put some more people on it. Let's raise the goblins up, because they've got to at least try and do something. I probably should mark this guy. So we're going to. Let's see if a troll gets up. We're not going to try massively to... We're not going to attack with him at this point. 2480, when the underworld creepers played against the greenfield grass huggers. Move you along to get a plus one. Dates, Jim. You'll have to refresh my memory. I see. And we're going to go blitz attack, because that means we can move afterwards. Oh, he doesn't have dodge. They had two halflings standing on each other, dressed as an ogre. Oh, what an impressive tactic. And very simple. I'm going to move you to there. The reason we're moving him to there is because that increases the number of tackle zones that are on that ball, meaning that they've got less chance to actually do anything useful with it. So from that, I think what we need to do is we need to move you up to there and just cover the war dancer. He does. End turn. Now, I'm quite happy with that turn, to be honest. That now gives us a chance, actually, to score. Well, not quite. It depends what he does. He dodges. That frees up one catcher, unfortunately, but he's got a lot of movement. There's plenty of people who could get to the ball, but they've got to go through a lot of tackle zones to do it, and not all of them have their dodge. If Scudder Bob could have a go at it here. One back and there. Two GFIs. He can actually get the ball if he picks it up. He's got a reasonable shot of it, to be honest. Tackle slip. He's got to put pressure on the ball, because if he gets tackle zones on the ball, that gives me a negative one to actually do anything here. So a GFI and a dodge in order to get on the ball. If he goes another one, and in fact what I might do now is just blitz. I'm going to surf him this point. Just look at the if his linesman isn't covered, he's getting blitzed. Yep. To prevent the small minority of so we have a we have additional dice on him. We've got a rerolls. Let's go for it. They might as well stay home and push it on cable vision. And no. One surfed elf. Viewers should close their eyes. This violence is barely acceptable. Yep, thank you. Nonsense, Jim. It builds character. It does build character, actually. What else can I do with you? I can move you back to there. I'm not overly planning a lot here, so. Right, let's move you up to there on the off chance that something happens. This goblin needs to move to there without picking up the ball. Then, what else can I do? I should probably have put some more cover on this, actually, because if he fails to pick it up now, it's going to be embarrassing. The player gets hold of the ball. Right, do I go double GF? No, it won't work. So you stick to there. Next up, Smashy McSmasherton. Smashes and follows. Mighty blow. Poetry in motion. What we'd like to see more often. Moves to there. I'm going to run out of time, but at least I've positioned enough people to sort of help out there. 40-second Blood Bowl is quite interesting. I like this format in a lot of ways, because it's forcing. You can't do everything. You've got to do whatever you can. At this point, he's got to dodge them away. The war dancer has dodge and leap, so that can get you can get away from that. Got a half cage on the ball here. Scudder Bob is going for glory. Oh, okay, he's actually knocked out as well. Right, I'm now going to go for some hurts, because these are elves. We need to hurt them if we can. In yesterday's Spike magazine, he said that Blood Bowl was like war. And no winners, just survivors. Okay. Oh, no. Don't abandon the match. Oh, you! Well, I know one team that'll be happy to... This was like the fourth turn! It's just not Blood Bowl. Dead right. I'm 100% with you on that one. Moreover, the crowd... Reroll the winnings. The coach. I'm off the joint. No, Bob, you can't do that. It's not I am disappointed. Okay. You know why I'm disappointed? Because That was building up to a good game. Ah, oh, that hurts. You, sir, I do not like, sir. Because this has now completely warped my team a little now here. Completely warped it. I now have Mr. Flibbles gained some points. It gave it to all my good guys, actually, to be fair. because I got two. The other person quit, so I get two of my things on there. But 160 gold. That's a good start overall. But oh, that annoys me. That annoys me. I'm let's playing, for God's sake. I need a full game. You. Ah. Okay. So what I've learned from this is I like the 40-second format. I hate people who decide, you know what? For turn four, it's all over. Ugh. Well, I might do more of this, but God damn it. All right, until next time, folks.